Certainly much less so. Today, one does not even have the right to protest at a presidential appearance. We have things called free speech zones. News crews are not allowed to film the return of military caskets from Iraq, lest the public get the awful idea that soldiers are being killed. This is censorship worthy of the Cold War Soviet Union, not the United States.
In old America, we would never censor free speech.
No, we would not.
Even though Woodrow Wilson jailed 5,000 Americans for speaking out against World War I. And locking people up without giving them a hearing, like Guantanamo.
Many of them innocent people.
FDR jailed 100,000 Japanese Americans. Almost all of them innocent. Many of them children. Spying on our own citizens. What about Nixon? He spied. Pop for Watergate. What about LBJ? He used the FBI to spy on reporters. According to the ACLU, Bill Clinton expanded stealth surveillance far beyond any previous administration ever, and that was during a time of peace.
Bill Clinton certainly never tortured people.
No. He practiced rendition, shipping suspects off to other countries like Saudi Arabia, Egypt, and they tortured for us. During the Cold War, we did human experimentation. Innocent people, college students, mental patients, government-run experiments. On unknowing victims. We tested everything from LSD to nerve gas. We exposed unwitting black men to syphilis, trying to discover a cure. We used them as guinea pigs. No, Judge, you haven't named one thing America is doing today that we haven't been doing for a long, long time.
We don't live in old America. This is a new world. The enemy isn't countries or states or governments. It's terrorists capable of attacking us here. Hell, they have attacked us here. This is new warfare requiring new tactics.
Including torture.
Absolutely. But we still stand for the same principles. That hasn't changed.
I'm confused. Those principles you say we still stand for, do they include human rights, the fair and humane treatment of prisoners?
I'm saying while those values remain important, we have to put them in perspective given the world we now live in.
And what world is that?
One of terrorism.
Right.
One where the Muslim world, much of it, hates us and would love to see the destruction of the United States.
Tell me, do you make any room for the possibility, any room whatsoever, that the conduct of our country, be it starting a war under false pretenses,
Democrat,
move to strike? This isn't Republicans versus Democrats.
Oh, right.
The Democrats, virtually all of them, have supported the worst of Bush's policies. Only one Democrat in the Senate opposed the Patriot Act when it was first proposed. They stumbled over each other, rushing to sign a blank check. I hardly stand here as a proud Democrat.
Where do you stand as a loyal American?
Oh, come on.
We don't question your country in a time of war.
Why the hell not? That to me seems like an especially apt time to ask questions.
Mr. Shaw.
I don't know who the hell came up with the notion that one can't criticize this country and still be patriotic, but it was Cheney. Well, he was wrong. Some of our most noble patriots were dissenters.
There's a lot to criticize about America today. I realize that. Truth be told, I'm embarrassed by the current administration. Who isn't? But whatever one wants to say about George Bush, there can be no question that he loves his country. He once made a simple statement that, simply put, reflects who and what he is.
Simple?
Mr. Shore.
He said, you're either with us or against us. It is the most unpatriotic act of heresy imaginable. It's treason. If you love this nation, you cannot possibly find that acceptable.
Not too long ago, we set the example for the world on civil liberties and human rights. Today, we have this bipartisan piece of legislation, the Patriot Act, that criminalizes free speech, authorizes warrantless searches, allows for wiretaps without probable cause. People can now be locked up on suspicion alone, denied due process or even a hearing. As for foreign nationals, forget it. They can be deported for what they say or think, even if they're completely law-abiding. They can be kept from ever entering this country under the ideological exclusion rule, again, based on what they say or think. All this accomplished by a bill that our leaders rushed to pass just 6 weeks after those towers came down. Did you read the Patriot Act, Judge? Members of Congress certainly didn't. It was pushed through with so much haste, there was almost no deliberation. Because few, if any, members of the House or Senate had bothered to read it. Most still haven't. A bill that mocks our Constitution and moves us ever closer to tyranny. We now round up suspects and throw them in detention camps, claiming they're not prisoners of war, so that we may torture them in violation of the Geneva Convention. We set up these camps in Cuba and other foreign locations. This is not something done by a government with moral integrity. It does not reflect a nation with a conscience. And let's talk about the torture. This isn't slapping around some suspect who knows of a ticking bomb. We now use torture as a matter of course. We use it against people just to see if they have information, any information. Torture is no longer the exception, but the rule. It's systemic. Waterboarding, sexual humiliation, extreme psychological and physical abuse. We all know the horrors of Abu Ghraib. And those orders came from the very top. George Bush knew and approved of these tactics, as did Rummy, Condi, Dick, Ashcroft, Tenet, even Colin Powell. They all knew and participated in creating the policy, as did many others. And yet not one high-ranking officer or member of this administration has been held accountable. Not one. We set up these secret prisons using techniques modeled on the dungeons of Egypt. We chain prisoners to ceilings. We subject them to simulated drownings or sexual abuse. This is not moral leadership. This is not the conduct of a country that regards the law or respects human rights. And the country I speak of is not Egypt or Saudi Arabia or even North Korea. It's the United States of America, my country, your country. Said to me that I cannot know the experience of lying down at night and facing the idea of losing America. Since September 11th, 2001, I think most of us have laid down on many a night and imagined exactly that. But I wonder, what is it about America that we most fear losing? And I wonder, how much of that have we lost already? We stand here today asking you to defend a democracy that our Congress and our president refuse to defend. We're asking you to stand up for the Constitution, which every judge is duty-bound to protect. We ask you to stand up for an America that 60 years ago, our soldiers stormed a beach in Normandy to defend. This case is personal to you, and it's personal to me. It's personal to everyone in this courtroom. I love this country, Denny. Sometimes I just don't recognize it anymore.